devil. You were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain. The sun, your work on earth is done. Go to heaven, shout love for the Father and the Son. Oh, how we cried the day you left us. Gathered round I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high on that mountain. Son, you
gathered here this evening for the service of Brother Frank Beverly, and I trust you are, as well as myself, for the testimony of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because if it wasn't for him, none of us would be here. I think about this thing that's got everybody looking like they're going to rob a bank or something, and you know, we turn to everything but the one we need to, that's God. He can stomp this stuff out and put it underfoot if the people that are called by God's name would humble themselves and really cry out, we'd hear from heaven. And the Bible says heal our land. You know, even the land gets sick, let alone people. May God bless you. We love you today, and we won't take up a whole lot of time. Frank was not only a good friend to me, but also a cousin. and always thought a lot of him, him and Barbara. And some of us won't know. I said, well, you ought to remember. I said, every time something happened in the family, they would be there. You could depend on it, supporting you. And, you know, that's something that's getting less and less, supporting one another. And a lot of people has asked me in time, Clayton, who was you named after? Old man Clayton Davis at Telmore? I wasn't named after a Davis. I was named after Clayton Dyson. Aunt Cora's husband. One young one, they had Bess, and then he had two in Florida. Good-looking girls. Last time I seen them was at his funeral. Well, we not have to go whatever the Lord gives us, and he said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Frank knew that. He was in the center. I truly believe he was in the center of God's will. He loved the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. He loved his family, loved his church. I believe that's the order we need to keep things in. And family is a strong thing, strong ties. Don't matter what comes and what goes, we have to support one another. And sometimes it might not be what we want to, but still, we have to look at it in a godly manner. And I believe that's what Frank done. He making the lie down in green pastures. He leads beside the still water. Still water, that's deep water. And he was deep with his, if you want to call it religion, salvation. Everybody's got a little religion, but, you know, some people got salvation. Salvation will stand, religion will fall. Everybody up in higher places everywhere, if you talk to them, they, oh yeah. And say, a lot of people say they believe in God, but do people really believe in God like they ought to believe in God enough to put everything in his hands and say, Lord, here it is, you take care of it, because I can't. I have to do that myself, because I can't take care of it. God has to take care of me. And the older I get, the more I need him. And this Bible here before me, that's what we need to read. It's more and more. Every time we get a chance, we need to have our nose in the Bible. Will that get me to heaven, preacher? No, you'll have to have what Frank had, what Jesus told Nicodemus. You've got to be born again. Born of the Spirit of Almighty God, which means the Holy Ghost. That you might know the difference in right and wrong. And when you step out there, and you will, you'll fall from time to time. And you call it error, sin, or whatever, but you'll have to say every now and then, Lord, forgive me in the name of Jesus. I didn't intend to do that. I didn't intend to say that. But you know, the old devil's always after us. It wasn't no different with Frank than it is me or anyone else. But you know, God's grace is sufficient. And that is in us is stronger than that that's in the world. That's where people is weak and they want to bend to the world. You don't have to bend to the world, bless God. You're a child of the King. You're just as good as anybody. You may be barefooted, but you got more than they have because you walk on streets of gold. I believe that. I believe what the Word of God says. And Frank was a good family man. For as I know, and like I say, he loved the church. He loved the members of the church and pastors. And he loved me. He's always cutting up with me, always. And, of course, I enjoyed that. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. That's where we need to stay. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. We all know that. We probably learn it at school. Thou prepareth a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. My anointeth my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's a great promise, ain't it? I'm telling you, you can't beat that. Rent free. Whatever you need, and you know, and you might be a Mormon here today. I got a lot of Mormon friends, but I had a service over at Pierce. Mormons on each side of me. The one behind me got at me and said, well, sister, don't worry. You'll be crying with the brother in heaven. You'll be laughing with him. And I thought, man, you just left the Bible. The Bible says God will wipe every tear from your eyes, but, you know, they got another book. But this is the book. And I find in there when the Old Testament, it said the last of the prophets. So we need to be led by the Spirit of God. That's what Jesus said, expedient, I go away. If I go not away, the comfort won't come. But if I go, he said, I'll pray the Father. In other words, I'll ask the Father, and he'll send him, and he'll be in you, and he'll bring all things to remembrance. That I've told you about. You ever been reading the Bible? You go to church that Sunday, and the preacher flips over there, and you say, man, I just read that. That's wonderful, ain't it? That you did just read that. God works with all of us if we let him. And like I said, I don't worry your patience. Frank was a good mortal man, but most of all, a good Christian man. And all these promises that David talked about, 23rd Psalm, he received them. And we don't know. I've heard preachers say, oh, he'll be eating breakfast with the Lord. And well, I don't know nothing about that. Bless God, I've never been to heaven, never been to hell, don't want to go. But I ain't going to tell you what's going on in heaven because I don't know. And you don't either. I ain't never seen an angel. I've been in the presence of them. I believe I've been where I could have elbowed one of them. But it's foreseeing one I had. The Lord might let us see one sometime. I don't know. We don't know. But it's good just to be in his care, to know when you pillow your head of a night that if you go on out like the brother did, that all will be well. Barbara, we love you and the children, grandchildren, all of you. Anything we can ever do you, don't mind calling us. I've thought about y'all a good bit. We used to be in church together a good bit, revivals and different things, and everything seemed like it slowed down. It's no more than the work of the devil. That's exactly who's doing it. Enters every way we can. Because you'll notice a lot of churches, when they close their door for a few weeks, when they come back, they've lost a few. Next time, same thing. We don't need to run from God's house. We need to run to God's house. That's where we need to be. We need to get together and pray and lift up our voice. It's all right if you want to wear a mask. It's all right if you want to sit in your car and truck, but be at God's house, around it somewhere. Because that's where the Lord's looking for you. If you got a pastor, he's looking for you. May God bless you. Our Father, which is in heaven, we thank you, God, for this day that you made and give to us, Lord, to bring you honor, glory, and praise. Lord, we pray for this family. Lord, we know it's not easy, and we know the hardest time is yet ahead. Lord, when they go and look for him in his favorite chair, wherever, and they don't see him, Lord, there'll be breakdowns. I've had them. They'll have them. And Lord, just bless them, and God, do that for them. We know, God, you don't ever put more on us than we can bear. And Lord, if it gets heavy, we know, Lord, you got helper springs on us we can handle. And we just thank you and praise. Pray you bless every soul that's gathered here today, God. Bless our household. There's this everyone lost, I pray, God. I've said something that'll stir their heart and soul, make them want to be a child of God. These and all things we ask and thank you for, in the sweet name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. I heard a few of you hand clapping a little bit there, but I can spiritually see with my spiritual eyes Brother Frank clapping, raising his hands, shouting hallelujah. Let me just say to the family, Brother Frank, that your loss is our loss. No, not in the same way. I look over there at Barbara, and to have a faithful companion for 52 years, and they were together. And when I say together, I don't remember seeing Brother Frank, really, without seeing Barbara. They were together. And to his children, to Rob and her husband Bobby, and to Amanda and Freddie, you've lost a father. God bless you. To the grandchildren who have lost a grandfather, to the great-grandchildren who've lost a great-grandfather, and to the nieces and to the nephews who have lost an uncle, I just want to say once again, we suffer with you. To his church family who has lost a brother in Christ, we suffer with you. But let me assure you of something that you probably really already know. Your loved one, Brother Frank, is not suffering. His suffering is over. If you could see him now, spiritually speaking, you wouldn't want to call him back. Brother Frank doesn't need oxygen. He doesn't need a hospital bed. He doesn't need a medicine cabinet. You see, what Mary Lee and Mary was singing, he's in Beulah land, that home eternal, which is a glorious place where there's no pain and suffering. That's what we can look forward to if we follow in the footsteps of Brother Frank. What a testimony Brother Frank has left behind. When I think about Brother Frank, I think of one word, and that's servant. He was a true servant of the Lord Jesus Christ. How do I know that? Why would I say that? Because he served his church. He served the people of his church. I don't know how many times, even before I even went to Hosanna Church, I would see Brother Frank in the hospital along with Pastor Chester Chancey, and they would be visiting someone in the hospital. You see, he was a strong right arm to his pastor. He was a servant of prayer. I called on Brother Frank many times to lead in prayer because I loved to hear the man pray. He could pray. And sometimes I would just sit and listen as he would touch the throne of grace for someone who was sick or for his family. Sometimes he would even pray for me. What a wonderful thing to know that you had someone at your side to lift you and hold you up in prayer. So he was a servant of prayer. Brother Frank was a servant of worship. Those of you who were in church with him, he was one of the first ones to get to church and sometimes one of the last ones to leave. When the Spirit hit him, whether it was in song or whether it would be in the Word, Frank would raise his hand. He would shout amen. Hallelujah. You see, he was a servant of worship. He was a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's a testimony. He left us a great testimony. When I was thinking about scripturally what in God's Word, I was asking, I said, God, where can I go in your Word for Brother Frank? I went probably to a dozen scriptures. And I would have never thought in 100 years that God would lead me to this scripture right here. But it hit me so strong as I was thinking about Brother Frank and I was meditating on the Lord. Just a few verses, four to be exact. But we all knew that toward the end, Brother Frank was suffering. He was hurting in his body. He wasn't feeling good. But let me say this. In his servanthood to the Lord, he would be in pain when he would walk in church. He would be hurting. He would grab his hip or his back. And he'd say, "Pastor Bill, pray for me, pray for me." And we would. But you know, that didn't keep him out of church. He was faithful. Not only was he faithful in his presence, but he served God with his means. He was a tither. He gave to the Lord. He believed in the principles of God's word. That's a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ. And what a testimony that is, that he's left behind for each and every one of us. But the scripture that I was led to is found in the 19th chapter of the book of Job. We all know the suffering of Job, how he suffered. But there was something that Job said in the 19th chapter in verse 23. And I was thinking about this could possibly be the words of Brother Frank to his family, to his church family, to his friends. This could be his words as a living testimony. You see, Job was the type of person that his family and his friends was wondering why. Even his wife said, "Why don't you just curse God and die?" But Job said no. He kept his eyes on God. He didn't understand everything. Brother Frank didn't understand everything, and you and I don't understand everything. But Job understood that God was God no matter what, whether you're on the mountaintop or when you're in the valley. And Brother Frank understood that too. So Job had a testimony of faith that he gave to his friends in the 19th chapter. And I can hear and Brother Frank leaving this to us today. His pen's this way. "Oh, that my words were now written. Oh, that they were printed in a book." The testimony that Brother Frank had, oh, that if it could just be recorded for you to look at and see and hold and touch. Verse 24 says that they were graven with an iron pen and lead in the rock forever. He would want you to know his testimony. He would want you to know just how strong a testimony he had for the Lord Jesus Christ. "I'm going to write it in stone. If they could just print a book and leave my testimony for you to read over and over and over again." Now, these was the words of Job, but yet I can hear Brother Frank saying this to his family and to his loved ones who he cared so much for. Now, what was the words? What was the words that he wanted graven in stone forever? What was his testimony that he wanted to be recorded in a book for us to read and read and read? Here's the words. It's printed this way. "For I know that my Redeemer liveth." Let me read that again. "For I know that my Redeemer liveth." No matter what I'm going through, no matter how much pain and suffering I have, there's one thing I don't know, and that is my Redeemer liveth. That's what I know. And he says it's my Redeemer, a personal relationship with his Lord and Savior. And he says, "And that he shall stand in the latter day upon the earth." The book of Thessalonians in chapter 4 says, there's coming a day that the trumpet's going to sound, And Jesus is going to come in a cloud. And those that have made themselves ready, that says the dead in Christ shall rise. For do you know what? Frank's going to meet us there. Woo! If the rapture took place right now, Frank's, he's ahead of us. He says that he shall stand in the latter day upon the earth. And here's what he says. And though after my skin worms destroy this body. You see, we know that the Bible says from dust we come, from dust we'll return. You see, the body that was given to Frank was not his permanent body. But he says it this way. He says, but though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. Wow. Though I be destroyed, yet in my flesh. You see, Frank knew that there's going to be a resurrection day. And that body would come out of the grave. He would have a new body and a new life, but he would behold his Redeemer with his eyes. That was Frank's testimony. I'm not just making these words up because I had one-on-one conversations with Brother Frank, and that was his testimony. He would say, Brother Bill, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. He says, for me to live is Christ, but for me to die is gain. He had a personal relationship with his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I believe that this loved one and this dear brother in Christ would have us to know that we need to make our calling and election sure. We need to make the same choice that Brother Frank made. If there's any prayer I could hear Brother Frank praying, it would be the prayer for his loved ones. He would wish no one would go to hell, that all would go to heaven. I don't know how many times Brother Frank would stand at the front of the church, and this is another part of his servanthood, and he'd say, Brother Bill, anoint me for Brother so-and-so. Just anoint me. He would stand in sometime for himself, but a lot of times he'd stand in for someone else. It could be one of his family members, but he was quick to stand in and touch the throne of grace. I remember one time, I wasn't feeling good. I come and I wasn't feeling good, and I think I kind of let him know, and Brother Frank just stopped right there. He come up to the front. He got the anointing oil. He grabbed me, anointed me, called the brothers up. They laid hands on me, and Frank led in prayer. That's a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to miss him. I'm going to miss him. But rest assured, this is not goodbye. This is not goodbye. If you've made the decision to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, the Lord and Savior of your life, this is not goodbye, Brother Frank. This is see you later. There'll be a day that we'll see him again. And that old hymn we'll all sing together. What a day that will be. When my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, and he takes me by the hand, leads me through that promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Don't you want to say that? Don't you want to believe that and hold on to that? I really didn't know when I first was prepared how easy this was going to be. But Brother Frank pretty much preached his own funeral by the testimony he left behind. Let me just say to the family once again, God bless you. We love you. We're praying for you. And we're going to miss your loved one. And I'm going to miss my brother in Christ. Let us pray. Father, as we come to you with heavy hearts, but also joyful hearts, because, Father, we know where Brother Frank is. Father God, we know that he is with you. We don't really know exactly what's going on there, but the fact that we know he's yours and that he's in the glorious kingdom of heaven gives us comfort and gives us blessed assurance that perhaps one day, Father God, if we stay the course, that we'll make that same journey and that we'll see Brother Frank once again. But Father God, I ask your special blessings upon Barbara and the children and the grandchildren, upon this entire family, oh God. I ask you to send your precious Holy Spirit to comfort them, to speak your perfect peace to them, that peace that passes all understanding, oh God. Provide for their every need. Watch over them. In Jesus' name, I humbly ask and do pray. Amen. And amen. God bless you.